This next guy coming to the stage, man, this is my dog, man. I've been knowing him more than half my life, man. This is one of my partners, man. He now resides out of Atlanta, but from the Naptown. He came home to do his thing, man, so I definitely want to make sure he had a spot to rock out, man. So I need y'all to start clapping your hands. Start clapping your hands. Start clapping your hands. Start clapping your hands. And make some noise for my dog, Mr. Donald for show. Martin, y'all, give it up for him. Give it up for him.
How y'all doing? Cut it, DJ. Cut it, DJ. How my white folks doing? We got a mix of everybody up in here. But we got some old and some young folks up in the building. If you was born in the 60s, make some noise. You part of the civil rights movement. Your mom and your daddy was marching with Martin Luther King and you was born on Selma. Any 70 babies in the building? Make some noise, 70 babies. Your daddy right now got a picture of him with afro, bell bottoms, and a cut-off t-shirt. Right there on the dresser said, that's how I got your mama. 80s babies in the building. Y'all already know y'all crack babies. Let's just get that over with, y'all. Crack babies. That's why y'all make the most noise. Y'all got that twitch. Talking about that's when they came out with ADHD, when you was born on crack. Any 90s babies in the building? Y'all was born on that good music. Tell me what you want. That's the only part I know. I grew up in church with Marcus. Tell me what you need. This is how the choir was marching. Tell me. Anything out the 90s, we don't give a damn about you. We can't stand y'all. And I'm getting older. Listen to me. I'm glad I'm getting older. Round of applause if you petty. Petty people in the building. Petty, you look petty. You look like you just take toilet paper from the nigga. You know what I mean? Nigga, you ain't using this toilet paper. This is the decorative toilet paper. Use the one ply. But I'm getting older, and what I love, I'm a petty because I'm a petty son. Because the older I get, the older my mama get. So guess what? I'm raising my mama. That's why she in the car right now. I know y'all ain't tripping. I spend 35% of my life in the car while she in the grocery store. 200 degrees, you sitting there eating on a candy necklace. Then she got crazy things to say. She said, if you die, I'm gonna kill you. What? So I'm a petty son. So I raised my mama like she raised me. So I take her to Walmart. She ready to get out high. I said, no, come back. I got some instructions for you. Don't ask for nothing. Don't touch nothing. Matter of fact, don't even look at nothing. Coach, sit her in the back seat of the car. Because that's why I said it. We drive. She gets excited when she see the golden arches. I say, I know you ain't. Because we got food at home. I ain't playing with you. Tell her to go outside. I said, when you go outside, don't be coming in and out. Because we ain't going to be air conditioning outside. Matter of fact, if you get thirsty, there's a water hose on the side of the... She called me the other day. She called me the other day and she said, son, why is this electric bill in my name? I said, oh, really? Serious? Because when I was a child, all your bills was in my name. I had bad credit at 3 years old. I'm petty. And I'm petty because my mama was a savage growing up. She's from 43rd and State. She's from Robert Taylor Homes, Chicago, Illinois. One of the roughest projects ever created on this earth. And she's hood. to this day. And we was talking about being hood. You know you hood when you older than your uncle. I had to babysit my uncle. Uncle John John, go to bed. Uncle John John, get in the car seat. You know you hood when you use dishwashing liquid as bubble bath. Some of y'all did that tonight. Tell me that's some new perfume. No, baby, that's just joy. I come from a savage type of life because my mama was savage. She did savage things. She said savage things. You got to understand, we feared God and we feared our mama. And depending on the day, we feared our mama sometimes more. I'm going to tell you an example. She raised four boys in Flint, Michigan. Water. So that's what we was raised in Flint, Michigan, in the roughest part of town. All four of us, we got caught shoplifting. And so we got caught. They took us back into the security room, and they said, oh, you're all under. They was about to call the police. They said, oh, you all underage. We need to call your mama. We said, nah, stick to the plan. Stick to the plan. We safe around policemen than our mama. And the reason why, because my mama was a savage, we had three types of discipline in our house. We had the whooping. We had the beating, and we had the killing. So let me like break it down for you. Like, for instance, this generation, this is why I don't like this generation, because it's totally different. See, when we grew up, you weren't allowed to be around grown folks. You weren't even allowed to be in the same room with grown folks. For Thanksgiving, you had your own little small little table to the side. You didn't even sit with grown folks. So when you interrupt your mama while she's talking on the phone, mama, pow! The backhand, that wrist was the whooping. Then what we had was the second one was a beating. We used to have on our wall a wooden fork and a wooden spoon. Now, if you was a visitor, you thought that was decorations. But if you lived in the house, that was weapons. This particular time, I was 6'1", my mama is 4'3", so this is my time. I'm smelling myself. So I'm going to do what I want to do. So I go outside because, you know, you had to be in before what? We all had the same mama. This particular time, I was like, I'm the man. I'm 6'1", she 4'3", she 4'3", she ain't going to do nothing to me. So I go outside, I play soccer. I play baseball. I play basketball. I play every sport you can play. And I waited. I stood under the street light and wait till it came on. It then got so bad, I waited till the mosquitoes came around. I come home. She's standing right there in front of the screen door. I look at her and I say, excuse me. That's what my brothers and them say. Oh! Fam behind me, bro behind me, I could see her. She was doing like this. So she took the weapon, the fork off the wall. She hit me with it. It broke. Bow! It broke. I said, no weapon formed against me shall prosper. She said, oh, is this what we doing? Is this what we doing? Fam, she called my brother down, George. He 5'3". What are you going to do to me? Fam, she picked my brother up. And she started beating me with my brother. third one was a killing. There's something that you have on your body right now that you can remember. Mine was the 3rd of September, 1992. I acted a fool all week in school. She didn't say a mumbling word. I know y'all know that West Side. West Side. So I acted a fool. I come home. I'm getting off the bus. Ain't no homework on Friday. I'm ready to go play my Atari. She looks at me and she said, nope, I need you to take a bath and I need you to go to bed. I looked outside. It's only 3:00, so I still see the sun. But I remember what she did with my brother, so I said, let me go ahead and do this. So you got to understand, my mama didn't waste anything. We took baths all in the same water. And so if you was the last one, and if you was the last one, you had to take the water. So you know it was dirt all on top of the water. And so if you're the last one to take one, I'm the one created the Harlem Shake. Put my dry towel on the toilet, go in, close my door, close the curtain, I'm taking a bath. Hell spoke, said, get out. So I got out, I noticed my dry towel was not on the toilet. I'm looking around, I'm like, oh my mama, I know I put this towel down here. Hell spoke again and said, it's in the room. Now you gotta understand, to my right was hell, to my left was my room. I had to make sure Satan wasn't gonna come up and get me. So while I'm drenched and I'm going out like this, I'm like, hey. I didn't see Satan, so I began to walk to my room. And as I began to walk to my room, this is what I heard. Kill, 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 kill. Kill, 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 kill. Kill, 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 kill. So then I began to walk to my room. All of a sudden, I see my dry towel on my bed. I'm going in. Door slammed. My mama's on top of the door. She swooped down, and she kills me. And Christine, this is how you know you kill. When you cry like this. Ah! She would say crazy things like, this hurts me. I'm gonna get out of here. I just moved to Atlanta and I love Atlanta. It's a beautiful place to live. But you know, my mama told me, when you get down there, don't be dressing up in no dresses and don't be doing that ha-ha stuff. I said, no, I love Jesus. I'm not about to do any of that stuff. I said, I mean, I respect the community, but I know what you mean. My mama do what I'm supposed to be doing. So I had an audition. I go in the audition, soon they say, I'm 6'4", fine, I know I'm fine. But anyway, so I'm 6'4". I'm 6'4". And when I'm 6'4", I'm just knowing I'm gonna be a bodyguard or something like that, Sasha. I know DJ, so I know I'm gonna be somebody like that. The first thing they said, I want you to be a hairdresser. Now I'm gonna remember what my mama told me. You ain't gonna be doing no ha-ha, and you ain't gonna be doing all that stuff. I said, I can't. Then they pushed the contract over to me and showed me all the money they wanted to pay me for being a hairdresser. The movie come out in January. But, hey, y'all, my name is Donald for Show Martin. God bless y'all. Yeah.